Hi guys! Okay, ang init, my God. Okay, today is March 3, 2018. My eye is still not feeling well. I know, I look like someone hit me in the face. Alam nyo to, alam nyo yung kantang yan. Naiinis ako dyan. Not because I don't like the song, but you know, it makes you remember certain people in their life. And this reminded me of a very close friend of mine that unfortunately left me hanging. And I'm really pissed off. Literally, this friend left me hanging. I was dangling from a swing when I fell down and hit my head. And this was me. It was a birthday party. If my memory serves me right, she literally just like left me because she was pushing me really hard. So I was sabi ko, ayoko na, I don't want to, no. And then she just like let go and then ran off. And I was like, what? I nearly died that day because I was terrified of heights. So I was like going really fast and really high that I was panicking. I was crying and then I fell down the swing and hit my head hard in the cement. I got like a huge bump in my head because I hit the floor like this. Played a lot during the 90s. And then the step was like, what was the step? Paano yung sabi ba? I think my mom bought this. I don't think my family will buy this kind of book, but it shocked me. And this was owned by a certain Toto Labasan. Ang dirty! From the title itself, you would probably know what this. Okay, pakita ko sa inyo to. Guys, total sex, an illustrated guide to the ultimate pleasures of physical love. Introduction by the noted authority on the psychology of sexuality, Albert Ellis, PhD, and then this was written by Dan Avalo. Published by Ace Books, a division of Charter Communications Incorporated, a Grosset and Dunlap company, and this was bought, I think, in New York City. And if you're asking and wondering kung binuksan ko to at binasa, I did go through some chapters. Kasi very detailed, okay? Very detailed ang librong ito. Wait lang. Very detailed yung libro, okay? In terms of chapters, this has 5 chapters lang naman. Pero they were divided into several sub-chapters or sub-contents. Like, there's the new acceleration of sexual growth, from orgasms to fireworks, from orgasms to fireworks to explosions. God. The art of being a continually better lover, enjoying all life's love at once. Yun yung five chapters. Pero ano, binasa ko to. To be honest, I'm at the age that I'm not supposed to be ashamed of sex. But this book is something that you will cringe reading. Kasi yung mga terminologies niya was very, how do I say this? Very professionally done that you wouldn't think people would think this way. But this was published during the 1970s, so I was not born in 1976, so I don't know how people talk that time. But oh my god, very
open ang librong ito about sex and the orgasm, like the art of achieving orgasm. And it's weird, okay, for a girl like me talking about sex from a very conservative family is very taboo, but I'm open to it. You know, sex isn't really a big thing for me to hide. Okay, so right now I have to go, I have to eat kasi parating na yung dinner ko, so kakain muna akong dinner. I'll talk to you guys later pag dumating na yung food ko.
Hi guys! Okay. Sabi ko mag-vlog ako pag dumating na yung dinner ko. 10-9 o'clock na. Wala pa yung dinner ko. 9:20 na nga to be exact. Okay. May kukwento ko sa inyo guys. Sobra akong natawa. This just happened to me earlier and I was chatting with a friend of mine na ang tagal ko nang hindi nakausap. Like the last time I talked to her was back in 2012. Girl, 2012! Alam mo, even magkita kami. Last time I saw her was in 2012, yata 2011. That was the last picture we had on Facebook kasi I checked. But she messaged me out of the blue. So I was surprised. Sabi ko, oh, hi, good. Nag-hi siya sa akin. Sabi niya, hi sis. Tapos nag-hi back ako. Tapos nag-usap kami. Chika-chika for, parang catch up for the last several years na hindi kami nag-usap. Then, surprise, she mentioned, uy, nagbukas ka na pala ng bakery. Sabi niya, nakakatuwa naman. Sabi niya, nakakaingit ka naman. You were able to start the business on your own. Eh, sabi ko, yeah, it's a small bakery. Ganyan, I told her about it and stuff like that. Tapos, walang pakundangan. Sabi niya, girl, pwede mo makahiram ng pera sa'yo? Mga 15,000 lang kailangan kasi namin sa school ng anak ko. Gumanon si ate girl. Eh di ako, nagulat ako 15K. Parang, okay, when it comes to money matters, money and friends do not mix. Okay? Kasi, sometimes, the best of friends will be the worst of enemies because of money. Believe me on that. Tapos sinabi ko sa kanya, girl, gusto yun man kitang mapahiram. Wala din akong pera ngayon kasi medyo mahirap ang buhay ngayon sa bakery. Hindi kumikita masyado ang bakery. And I'm open to say that, okay? I barely get enough money to support my mom. So sabi ko sa kanya, as much as I want to, hindi ko talaga kaya. Sabi ko, hindi ko kaya, girl. Tapos sabi niya sa akin, ah, ganun ba? Sabi niya, madali mo naman makikita yun. Madali mo naman kikitahin yun. For sure. Bakery yan, marami bumibili. Okay, one of the misconceptions of people when you have a business is not every day is a good day for business. For me, weekends are actually the worst. Weekdays are fine. Holidays and weekends are the worst days for me. Because yung sales namin sobrang baba pag weekends. Mataas siya pag weekdays. So sinabi ko sa kanya, girl, hindi naman kasi kinukadali yun. Sabi ko, masarap sabihin na madali lang kitain yung 15K. But in my case, I have people to pay to work here. I have utilities to pay. I have rent to pay. And rent alone for this place is actually cheap na yung rent dito sa place na to eh. Compared to a
ko pang bumili ng ingredients, kailangan kong bayaran yung tao, kailangan kong gawin yung... Ang dami ko kailangan gawin. So sabi ko sa kanya, girl, sorry, hindi kita makapahiram. As much as I want, hindi kita makapahiram. So sabi niya, ay, ganun ba? Sabi niya, akala ko kasi, true friend ka, gumanun siya sa akin. Doon ako parang, doon nag-init yung tenga ko. Sabi ko, hindi naman masusukat ang pagkakaibigan kung mapapahiram kita o hindi. So sabi niya, babalik ko rin naman within a week kasi kailangan lang ng anak ko kasi mag-e-exam ata siya. I don't know. Sabi ko, okay, pero hindi talaga kita mapapahiram. Ginoon ko siya, pinag-angka ko na. So sabi niya sa akin, ah, ganun ba? Okay, I understand. Tapos blinak niya ako. Blinak niya ako sa Facebook friend. Okay, guys. Ito tatandaan nyo. Hindi dahil hindi kayo pinahiram ng isang tao, isang basis na yun for you to block them on social media. Alam mo yun, parang isang malaking what the fuck moment yun para sa akin. Kasi parang, kasi hindi kita pinahiram, block agad ako. Girl, don't me, wag ako. Parang, ako, I would rather go to my relatives to ask for money if I needed it. But I wouldn't ask my friends. I have a lot of friends that have money, pero hindi ko ginagawa. Alam niyo bakit? Kasi nga, friends and money do not mix. Alam mo yun, magkakasiraan lang kayo dahil sa pera. I almost lost one of the best people as my friend because of money. And kilala niya kung sino siya. Nanonood siya ng vlogs ko. But I paid off my debt dun sa taong yun. Kasi nga, during the time na nagka-problema ako, nanghiram ako sa kanya, but then when I started the business, this business, unti-unti ko siyang binayaran. Sabi ko, pasensya na, hindi kita nabayaran in time, but now I do have a business now. I can pay you back, little by little. At tinanggap naman niya yun. And we rekindled the friendship. So, dun sa nag-block sa akin sa Facebook, I'm sorry. But I don't think, even if you unblock me on Facebook and message me again, I wouldn't consider you as my friend anymore. Kasi kung ganun po ituring mga kaibigan mo, napakasamang tingnan. Natawa na lang din ako. I'm not gonna act petty about it kasi some people are like that. Hindi natin may iwasan yan eh. Some people will treat you as crap if they don't know your worth. And ako, I know my worth. I have my principles. So, yun. Sorry na lang sa kanya. Hindi kasi ako ganun kadaling maglabas ng pera right now. Kasi nga, kailangan ko din. I mean, kung pwede ka na magsabi ng pahingin pera, diba? Kung ganun kadaling magbigay ng pera ang ibang tao sa akin, oh my god, I'll be rich now. Kasi magaling ang charms mo. Charot! Okay. Siguro kaya ako ganito kasi gutom na ako. I'm exhausting all my energy because I'm hungry. Two hours delayed na ang pagkain ko. Hindi ko na kaya. Oh my god. Atak to guys later. Titiisin ko na lang yung gutom ko kasi malapit na rin ako mag-close. So, titiisin ko na lang yung gutom ko guys. Okay, I'm gonna be packing up now. It's about 10:30. What the hell? I heard a pop. Oh, okay. Wala pa rin akong dinner. So, I'll just eat at home. Okay, I posted something on my personal Facebook account and my Facebook page. I said I'll be posting an online sale. Pag-post ko nga sa Instagram. I'll be doing an online garage sale. So, this will be like a week later, pero I'll let you guys, if you follow me there, you kind of know already. Wawa. Okay. Pag-post ko muna sa Instagram. Magpa-pack up na rin kasi ako. Pack up na ako. ako. Eh, magkakaroon ako ng online garage sale. So, ayusin ko siya tonight. Kasi nga, I want to get rid of stuff before I close the bakery. So, I have funds for myself, and funds for my mom, and funds for my uncle. Pero mura ko lang ibibenta lahat. Ayun. Kasi talagang gusto ko lang madiscuss yung mga gamit ko ngayon. Kasi nakaka-stress na. Ang dami ko masyadong bag. Ngayon ko lang na-realize. Kasi nung naglinis ako ng... Naglinis ako ng closet ko the other day. I just imagined I have accumulated so many bags that I don't even use. Some of them impulse buy. So, I have to get rid of them. So for now, papak na si ate girl nyo. Magsasarap ako ng bakery. After nun, ayun. Magkakain ako, tapos mag-aayos ako, tapos magtulog na ako. I'm so hungry